Students, today we are going to start one of the chapter which is, I think, is very much important at today's point of time, that is our environment. It appears to be a very busy chapter, but it is very significant, at least at today's point of time, when we are eager to destroy our environment. We are mercilessly destroying the environment in which we live, and as a result we are creating numerous hazards. Day after day we are creating numerous hazards which are caused due to the destruction, merciless destruction of this environment in which we live. So at today's point of time, standing at today's point of time, I think though this chapter is easy one and chapter is, but it is very important one also. Clear? So we know that we have several conditions here and several geographical regions. So accordingly our environment, all the surroundings also changes. And today we are going to discuss what are the components of our environment, how they interact, and all this. So let us start with our topic.
Now, students, what do you mean when we say our environment? We actually mean whatever there is in our surrounding. Clear? So when we are calling our environment, we are actually meaning our surroundings. Now this environment, so it is a huge thing to define an environment, and to study it we can divide it into small ecosystems. Now what is ecosystem? Ecosystem is the interacting living organism along with the non-living surrounding of a particular area. So what do you mean by ecosystem? Ecosystem is the interacting living organism, like you see human being, animals are there, plants are there, microbes are there. So all these living organisms are constantly interacting with its surrounding, clear? With its surrounding, physical surrounding. So that is ecosystem. When it is considered in a particular area, we call that ecosystem of that particular area. Now, so you can think of various ecosystem like pond ecosystem, garden ecosystem, forest ecosystem, ecosystem in lake, ecosystem in snow-covered area, ecosystem in snow-covered Antarctic. So various ecosystems are there. If we consider the variety of our geographical areas, we will find various ecosystems are there. Clear? With its own desert ecosystem, so with its own unique assemblage of organisms as well as the non-living abiotic component, there are various ecosystems on Earth. Now, but still, if we consider some basic components of ecosystem, we find that the components of ecosystem can be divided mainly into two parts. One is the living organism, that is the biological part of the ecosystem. So all living organism, plant, animal, microbes, clear? We human beings are also under animals, so all these constitute the biotic component of the ecosystem. So all these constitute the biotic component of the ecosystem. And the non-living, so can you think of some non-living components? Obviously air, wind, temperature, water, soil, light. So all these will be under non-living or physical environment, or it is called abiotic environment, component of the ecosystem. So all the non-living, clear all the non-living things. So whether it is the wind, it is air, or it is light, all are comes under the physical part of the ecosystem, that is the abiotic component of the ecosystem. Clear? Now, so ecosystem is the interacting, clear, interacting living organism along with the non-living or the abiotic components, clear, in a particular area. So when we are considering a particular area, suppose we are considering a pond. So what will be the component of the pond ecosystem? Clear? A pond ecosystem will constitutes various parts. Now suppose if we consider a pond ecosystem, what we are supposed to see? We will see that first of all, it is the soil which is making up the pond. Clear? Next, the pond, this whole part is filled up with water. So these are the aquatic ecosystem. There is air above, and there is dissolved air also, oxygen and other air also there in the salt is there. So all these forms the abiotic component of the pond ecosystem. So soil, water, temperature of the water, that salts which are present dissolved in water, gases which are present dissolved in water, so all these minerals present in soil, all this constitutes the light coming into the pond. So all this constitute the abiotic component of the pond ecosystem. Now we consider the biotic component. What are the biotic component? First of all, we will see the surface. We will find lots of green plants floating on the surface. So these are called phytoplankton. So phytoplanktons are the floating plants. Now there are numerous small microorganisms also floating. Clear? So small insects, all these are floating here. So these are the zooplankton. So floating animals, that is small insects and all, they are called zooplankton, and the floating plants are called phytoplankton. So all these are present in the surface, and there are large fishes. Clear? There are small fishes. There are various types of fishes, there are various types of aquatic animals, clear, and you can see here submerged plants also. So not only the floating, there are submerged plants, surface, there are deep rooted plants which are moving on the surface, there are numerous decomposers at the bottom, clear, and so all this constitutes the biotic component. So all this constitutes the biotic component. So biotic component, so pond ecosystem is a self-sustaining ecosystem. That means it can sustain without, it has respiratory gases that dissolved here. It can sustain the without the interference of the others. And it is the sun is the source of energy. So all these living organisms, clear, require a huge amount of energy. We require a huge amount of energy to maintain this ecosystem, and their source of energy is the sun. Clear? The sunlight is the source of energy for maintaining this huge ecosystem. So this is pond ecosystem. Now, so pond ecosystem can, now what do you think? Pond ecosystem is a artificial ecosystem or a natural ecosystem? Now, next we will come to artificial and natural ecosystem. Now, pond is often dug. Often the pond is made by digging. Clear? So, we are making it like garden. Clear? It is not the natural one. We are making the garden. Aquarium. It is totally, we are thinking what to be there in the aquarium. So those are the especially the garden aquarium, there's this only artificial ecosystem. Pond, after we dig, it grows naturally. Clear, it is maintained naturally. So to some extent, it may be under natural ecosystem, but garden, aquarium, these are all artificial ecosystem where solely what we want will be there. And there are numerous natural ecosystem. You can think even a snow covered peak, clear mountain peak, that is also ecosystem. There are maybe living creatures there, fine, the environment is there. So even Antarctica contains lots of microorganism, plants, animals, so that also constitute a particular ecosystem. Desert, where we find absolutely a different condition, like sand, clear, the desert plants and animals also varies from the normal what we see surrounding us. So that also forms a particular ecosystem. And so these are all mountain, snow-covered mountain peak, desert, ocean, lakes or rivers. All these are natural ecosystem. But pond, garden, clear, all these are artificial. Aquarium, all these are artificial ecosystem. Clear? Now watch various kinds of ecosystem. So snow-topped mountains, then mountains, rocky mountains. So mountains with barren lands as well as snow-covered regions. Mountain streams. Ecosystem describing the various mountain streams coming from the mountains. Water bodies. Ecosystem of various water bodies. Land ecosystem with not at that particular altitude but lower than that. So green mountainous valleys, clear, with rocky mountains and green valleys surrounding. Green valleys providing lots of pastoral lands. So all green valleys in the mountains. Ecosystem of lakes, clear. Various lakes, freshwater lakes, ecosystem of various freshwater lakes. So various lakes, rivers, ecosystem of various lakes, clear. This is especially for lakes. Ecosystem, these are newly formed lands on the rivers, clear, dried rivers. So they have a separate ecosystem, that of the common rivers, clear. So they are there, these are the sand covering in the rivers, at the base of the rivers coming out. These are the ecosystem of abundant lands, clear. These are the abundant land areas. So all these are the ecosystem of abundant land areas. You can see here very sparse vegetation, clear, as because already there was something, and so it is not densely vegetated but sparsely vegetated since it is abundant. But at the time will grow, it will, if we leave it like this, it will grow into forests. Plain lands in the, or valley like areas in the ecosystem at the base of the large well grown forests, clear, especially the mountain forest, well grown forest, it is the base of these forests. So river ecosystem, you can see here with a different river ecosystem with different organisms. Forest ecosystem but with sparse vegetation. This forest ecosystem but not densely forest. This is very, you can see here, mainly vegetation is very sparse but it is basically a forest. In grassland ecosystem, you can see here, these are the grassland ecosystem. Long trees, a lot of trees are very rare. Ecosystem of lakes in winter with migratory birds. So here the ecosystem will vary with the season also, clear. These migratory birds will come and they will change the normal ecosystem to a bit extent. Here it is the ecosystem of forest, but with, you can see there that the color of the soil, so it's not absolutely green, it's to some extent reed like soils. Clear? So you can see the basal vegetation is very rare, very less basal vegetation. Ecosystem of pond and plain land. Clear? Ecosystem of pond and associated plain land. Here also you can see here pond ecosystem. So this is also a pond ecosystem, depicting pond ecosystem in plain lands. Ecosystem of a garden. Clear? So absolutely an artificial ecosystem where the garden has been created by man. Now here you can see the ecosystem of a single plant. Clear? Single plant, a single tree can also provide an ecosystem. So here is the ecosystem of a single plant, where the plant is the producer with lots of the insects and all creature inhabiting on this plant. Clear? That also creates an ecosystem. The birds coming here all creates an ecosystem. So ecosystem can be called, a tree can also make an ecosystem.